Ensoniq Transwaves are a derivative of wavetable synthesis, and they are very similar in nature. Generally, transwaves take a source wave, like let's say a square wave, and gently morphs it into another wave over time. So by the time you scroll through the entire wavetable, you end up with something different. And all these waves have to be met at zero crossing, which is why an external program is often used. But we're not gonna do that today. We're gonna make transwaves the dirty way. So first, I have a looped wave of an OB8 synthesizer and a square wave. And I'm gonna break those down to their single cycle elements, which we can listen to here. And they sound pretty gross. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take those two waves and splice them together so that the OB8 single cycle wave is butted up against the square wave. And I'm gonna keep on repeating that till I get a long string of those single cycle waves butted up together. And I'm gonna use that as a source of making a trans wave. Let's listen to those two waveforms sound like all smashed together. Pretty gross, right? I know. So let's go about the business of turning into a trans wave. The first thing we're going to do is press Edit Wave on the Ensoniq ASR-10 and turn Loop Forwarding on. And in this menu, we're just going to go through the entire menu until we check every single option. So the start of the waveform is 0, we can leave it at that. The end time is at 99, that's fine. The loop start is 0, we can leave it like that. The loop end is 99. And here's where most of the problems occur for people. What we're going to do is set this loop endpoint to a small little number like 128 samples. The way transwaves scroll through the sample is by equal parts, and those equal parts are determined by the width of the loop. So we've set a small width here of 128 samples. So for each frame or snapshot that we move through the transwave, it will be moving in blocks of 128 samples. Now, if it were 99 like we had before, there'd be nowhere to go. There'd just be one big block, which would be the entire sample. So we want to set our frame to a small size. So when we scroll through, we'll move through in accurate, equal, small chunks. And from here, it's pretty simple. Loop position, we can leave at 0. Modulation, we're going to scroll until we get to transwave. This source that's highlighted here that says wheel, I've set it already to use the modulation wheel, but you can use anything. The modulation amount, this is kind of the depth of how aggressive you want to modulate through the wave. I've set it to 16, because I want to move as smoothly and as accurately as I can through this waveform. This range function is actually disabled with transwaves. All right, now we're done with the formalities. Let's take a listen to what this transwave sounds like as we scroll through it with the mod wheel. What if we start actually doing some synthesis and take advantage of the ASR-10's layering functions? Let's take a listen to the waveform now with some synthesis I've done by duplicating the waveform by an octave and a fifth. Still using the mod wheel, and I've added a filter to swell from a muted sound to a brighter sound. Let's listen to the same transwave patch with the dual delay effect from the ASR-10. And if you haven't figured it out by now, Ensoniq transwaves are a great tool for making up weird stuff. But what about for conventional stuff like, I don't know, hip-hop music? Let's take a basic hip-hop drum loop. And we'll take the same process that we did before to make this long loop into a trans wave. It's pretty cool, and that's only the tip of the iceberg with trans waves. Anyway, thank you for listening. If you liked and learned something today, subscribe to me here on YouTube and follow me on Facebook. In the meantime, peace.